Next thing we're going to look at are random numbers. Random numbers are, again, used all the time in programming. They're not actually random, so before I get a bunch of comments, they're not really random numbers. I know they're not really random numbers. They're pseudo-random because, you know, they're not actually random. That's why they call them pseudo. Anyway, but that's enough. That's fine. Let's talk about just making some boring, old, regular, random integers. So a lot of times whenever we're wanting to generate integers, we just want to do... Or when we're generating random numbers, a lot of times it's like a die roll. So generating random integers. So say that we wanted to generate numbers going from, so like generate a dice roll, like that. If we want to generate a dice roll, so remember dice can go from 1 to 6. So if I'm not mistaken, yes, rand I, 6. And the more I run it, I'm just running it a whole bunch. If you're wondering what I'm doing to make it like automatically run in a command window, I'm hitting Control Enter. Control Enter, Control Enter, Control Enter, Control Enter, Control Enter, Control Enter, Control Enter. Anyway, so you see I'm getting a whole bunch of random integers from 1 to 6? Alright. That's amazing. let's see. Now let's say I wanted to generate, I don't really know what this would be. What do you generate that's not starting at 1? Oh, I'm sure I'll think of something later. Generate something, whatever it's going to be, say from 10 to, let's not do that, let's do 11 to 16. So I'm just going to shift everything by 10. So, make sense? So if I wanted to generate some numbers from 11 to 16. So there's a couple of ways that you can do this, and I think there's another way over here. Yeah. So one way to do it is to say rand I, and I want to go 11 to 16. And as you can see, well, now I'm generating this number still, so there we go. Now I'm just generating that number 1 to 16, 11 to 16. So you see how those numbers are all 11 to 16? Good. All right. So this is one option, or what I can think about is the fact that I'm going to generate a number between 1 and 6, and then I'm going to add 10 to whatever that number happens to be. So does that make sense? Now this is actually really, really important in a minute when we're going to talk about random numbers more, but basically the idea is we are uniformly, where I can talk better. We are uniformly distributing numbers from 1 to 6. So let's say there's a 1, or 1, that's 1, from 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Alright? So we're randomly distributing numbers from 1 to 6. And let's say that those numbers, they all have an equal probability of being distributed between 1 and 6. So it looks like this. All this means is this is kind of like a way of saying that the chance that I distribute, or that I get a 1, is the same that I get a 6. So what I'm going to do is let's say that it starts 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16. So what I want to do is I want to take this guy and I'm going to shift him over. You're like, why are we doing this if there's another way to write it? Trust me. How about that? Just trust me. Is we want to shift that over here. Okay. So what we're going to do is we're going to generate the numbers 1 to 6 here, and then we're going to shift them over by 10 so that we get numbers 11 to 16. Okay. Does that make sense? We're going to shift the numbers, okay, from the normal distribution. All right, so we can do it that way. We can do it that way. Honestly, I always forget how to do this because it's just kind of weird, I guess, and just not my style. So I always forget to put the brackets on there, and I forget the syntax. So most of the time, I end up doing it this way. But those don't specifically need to be random or commented out. They're just there. So So what's cool about this, so let's say, see if you can come up with these, just to make sure that you know what's going on. Type out some code, make sure that you can randomly generate an integer from 1 to 12, make sure you can randomly generate an integer from negative 5 to 15. That one's a little bit trickier, but you might figure it out. Alright, so pause the video, give it a shot, see how far you can get on your own. Remember, this is like active learning and stuff. Alright, so let's pretend you did that. Alright, so if I randomly want to generate an integer from 1 to 12, now I wasn't actually storing these for anything, but I can, I can say x equals, I don't care that bad, but I'll go ahead and do it here. If I randomly wanted to generate an integer from 1 to 12, I could say, now don't say 1 to 12, because, yeah, see what that is? That's not what you thought you were going to get. What is that? 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, that's a 12 by, looks to be a 12 by 12 matrix. That's a 12 by 12 square matrix. So that's not how you do it. I'll show you. So if I did a 1 to 4, that's more obvious. That's clearly a 4 by 4 matrix of 1s. It's not what you want. So remember, if you wanted to randomly generate an integer from 1 to 12, all you put is the end value. And then you'll start getting a random integer somewhere between 1 and 12. Now, to randomly generate an integer from negative 5 to 15, you might have tried going like 1 to 15 and then trying to figure out what's going on. Of course, you can definitely do this. You can say negative 5 to 15, and that'll get you a randomly distributed number between negative 5 and 15. Or, and this one's just as fun, I want you to think about it. In the same context as this guy, so he went from, we don't know where we originally want to go, but right now we want to go from negative 5 to 15. So we want to think, well, this is really going to get shifted. So I need to shift this over to 1 by doing a plus 6. And so that means that this guy is going to get shifted over plus 6. So that puts him at 1, and that puts him at 21. So I could generate numbers from 1 to 21 and then shift them backwards by 6. They're like, but that's plus 6. Well, it's because I was working forwards, now I'm working back again. So this is a little weird, but it's more important to understand from a perspective of just like thinking and stuff. So what did I say? I already forgot. Randomly generate up to 21, and then I want to shift it back by 6. And in fact, that'll get me the same distribution of numbers, which is actually kind of fun. Yay! Randomly distributed numbers. All right. Now, uniform distribution, I've already kind of thrown that at you, but this isn't just working for integers. It can work for, and normally how whenever you're generating random numbers in programming languages, you're just generating fractions. Not even fractions, just random, well, I guess these count as fractions, but you know what I mean, just numbers. Floating point integer, floating point numbers. So basically what we do is we generally arbitrarily generate a number between 0 and 1. And to do that, the command is rand. If I just type rand over and over again, I'll just get, if you're wondering how I got it to pop up, I just hit the up arrow and then that went like that. So I'm randomly generating a number between 0 and 1. Like, will you ever get 0? Probably not. Will you ever get 1? Probably not. I guess you could. I've never seen it happen because, you know, the probability of it getting exactly 1 is, you know, pretty small. So now, if I was trying to generate numbers here, this is where that shift thing kind of goes into. So with the integers, it was easy-ish. I don't even know if it was easy, but it was good enough. So now I'd say that I'm just generating numbers randomly between 0. And so remember that the integers started at 1. So make a note of that somewhere. Integers. So rand I started at 1. And then that's supposed to be a 1. Rand, which is just like decimals, starts at 0. Okay, Okay, that starts at 0. So the idea now is that I have this thing here going from 0 to 1. So it goes from 0 to 1. Now, if I wanted to randomly generate numbers from 1 to, from 0 to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, what I'd have to do is take that random number thingy and stretch it out to make it go all the way to 6. Does that make sense? I'm going to take this guy here, who's at 1, and I'm going to stretch him out to 6. So if that makes sense, great. It has to do with transformations of graphs. But if I wanted to, so basically what I'm going to do is I'm going to rand it times 6, and that'll stretch it out by 6. But then let's say for some reason I actually wanted to go from, you know, 3 to 2, 3, 7, 8, 9. So if I actually wanted to go from 3 to 9, then what I would do is I would add 3 to that. So what I would do is after I've stretched it, then I'm going to go 1, 2, 3. And that's not going to work because my thingies weren't equidistant. If they were equidistant, that would work better. So let me do the whole process again with slightly better values, slightly better graph. Okay, so I'm going to try to do this a little bit better. So here we go. I'm going to try to draw a little bit straight. Okay, so I've got numbers from 0 to 1, and then 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. All right. So my goal is to do numbers from 3 to 9. All right. So what I look is from 3 to 9. That means there's a range of 6. All right. So there's a range of 6. And since it starts at 3, I have to shift by 3. All right. So you're always going to expand by a range first, and then you're going to do your shift. So here's my uniform distribution here. Okay, so there's my uniform distribution there. Now I'm going to expand it by, and I think I have something. I'm going to expand it by 6. So 2 times 3 times 4 times 5 times 6. You can see how bad that shading was. Right? So now that I've expanded it, I've expanded it by 6. Then what I'm going to do is I'm going to shift it. 1, 2, 3. There. That's much better. And now you can see that I'm going from 3 to 9. All right? And that's pretty much what we're going to do. If we are going to randomly generate numbers from one value to another, not integers. So what did we decide? We wanted to uniformly generate a number from, what was it, 3 to 9. Alright, so we have a random number. We're going to multiply it by a range of 6, and then we're going to shift it by 3. And now you see how we're getting these fractional values, these non-integer values, these real numbers. Alright, so are you convinced that these numbers are all between 3 and 9? Good. Alright, these numbers are all between 3 and 9. So now let's see if you can randomly generate, and these are all, we're just going to call all these uniform. Alright, randomly generate a number from 10 to 14. So if we're going to randomly generate a number from 10 to 14, I'll walk you through one more. We think about the range. So we start with a random number. We see what range we're looking for. Okay, so 9 minus 3 was 6. So 14 minus 10 is 4. So the range is 4. And we're going to shift it by 10. Ignore that first value. That first value is from the other random number. So I'll just look at that. So all those numbers, you see how they're between 10 and 14? Yes? Convinced? Okay. Now do a couple on your own. So randomly generate a number from, I don't know, 3 to 7. or 17. And then randomly generate a number from negative 5 to 15. We'll do that one again because it's fun. Alright, so again, ideally, pause the video. Try it on your own. See what happens. Give it a shot. Try to learn something. It'll be amazing. Alright, let's pretend you did that. Alright, so again, we're going to look at the range here. The range here, 17 minus 3 is 14. And please, please, please don't just memorize this process. Understand it. You're going to have way too much stuff in your head to try to get through your life memorizing stuff. Like, I remember whenever I first tried to do stuff this, I'd be like, okay, so it's rand top minus bottom plus bottom, and then I forget, is it bottom or is it top? And then I realize, wait a second, I don't have to memorize all this stuff. I just have to understand what's going on. Once I understand what's going on, it's way, way easier. Alright, so anyway, all these numbers are between 3 and 17. I don't actually see anything down as a 3 yet. There was a 3, okay. Alright, so now we want to generate a number from 5, negative 5 to 15. And hopefully you caught on the fact that this range is 20. 15 minus a negative 5 is 20. And instead of shifting it up, we're shifting it down. And now we're getting numbers between negative 5 and 20, or negative 5 and 15. Awesome? Awesome. All right, let's see what else we need to do. All right. All right, so now I want to make sure that you understand what you're going to get from a line like this. So if I type in a number like this, 110, what I'm actually getting is a 1 by 10 matrix of random numbers. So so as I'm going through here, let's say that I wanted to get a random distribution of just numbers like that. So like a 1 by 4. So this is actually going, this is not going to get you random numbers from 1 to 4, okay? What this is giving you is a 1 by 4 matrix of random numbers, okay? And this is just kind of fun. So now, let's see what happens. Can you create code to get a, I don't know, a 4 by 5 matrix of random numbers from 8 to 10, all right? So that's kind of crazy. So see what you can do. Pause the video for a second. Try this out. See if you can get a 4x5 matrix of random numbers from 8 to 10. Like, okay. So I pause the video because I'm totally trustworthy. Whenever you tell me to go pause the video, I totally do it because I want to be responsible for my learning and stuff. All right, rand 4x5. So that tells me what size I'm gonna get. So that's a 4x5. Yeah. So it's a 4x5 matrix of numbers. Now the range on those numbers needs to be 10 minus 8 is 2. And you see how those are all going between. This is actually easier than hitting a bunch because you can actually compare a whole bunch at the same time. And then I'm going to shift it by 8. And you can clearly see that those are all numbers from 8 to 10.